This is a proof of the statement that if a and b are non-zero integers such that a equals b, then 2 equals 1. This statement clearly is false because 2 is not equal to 1, and so this proof cannot be a valid proof. So what's wrong here? Well, from here up to here, there's really nothing wrong. The problem is from this second last statement to the last statement. The operation here was dividing both sides by a minus b times b. But why can't we do this? Normally, we can divide both sides of an equation by a non-zero value. But here, this is 0 because a is equal to b. So we are dividing both sides by 0. And dividing by 0 is not a valid operation. And that is why this is a false proof. In short, the proof contained a deduction that shouldn't have been made in the first place. A valid mathematical proof must be a sequence of statements starting from the premises or assumptions, leading to the conclusion, such that each non-initial statement can be logically deduced from the previous one. That essentially is the working definition of a mathematical proof. And using this definition of a mathematical proof, one can see that verifying the validity of a mathematical proof is rather straightforward. But coming up with a proof in the first place is a creative process. And so the question is, how does one go about doing that? We'll be looking at a few common proof techniques. They will help you get started. It's kind of like cooking. You need to know the basics, like how to use a frying pan and how to mix the ingredients before you can make a dish. And so I'll see you in the next video with an example.